dust to second down. Newton's got it in the gun. With two hands, he has it.
A player to watch today.
Tight end, Greg Olsen out of Miami.
Greg Olsen, a New Jersey boy. Grew up in the next town over from me, but he has the speed, pair of good hands, and he's one of Cam Newton's favorite targets.
Olsen's in the slot here for this play. Newton standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Makes the reception.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything. It's going to work, and they stop the offense at time.
I love everybody, welcome to football. I'm a better fan now because of the Colts. Suck.
The punt team is in place and ready to perform.
That's my opinion.
Hester's going to try and return this punt.
I'm going to trade off Jay Cutler person in the game.
Jay Cutler.
Well, we've talked so many times about Jay Cutler.
I hate that cracker.
It's time to see it all come together. He has talent and experience.
Oh, sorry for being racist. I don't support whites. I support black people. Like I said, I have my own opinions. Yeah, 14.
This running back hit the hole at full speed, and the defense had very little time to react. And that's how he got in the secondary, made a couple guys miss, and gets down there and gets a long run.
The Chicago Bears, this edition, well, you got a first.
He's always good.
What does he do with the offensive line this year?
It can't get worse, that's for sure. So I know Mark Trestman, the new head coach of the Chicago Bears, will get that straightened out, and he's going to give his quarterback, Jay Cutler, a better chance of being a successful QB in this league.
What do you see as the strengths of the Chicago Bears?
Well, you got Matt Forte at running back. That's pretty good. Jay Cutler, quarterback, he is proven that he can throw the ball down the field, a better athlete than people think. And then you have Brandon Marshall at wide receiver. So you got running back, quarterback, receiver there. Just fix this offensive line to give these guys a chance to start.
This starting lineup is brought to you by Snickers. When hunger hits, Snickers satisfies. He had no time to get set. Greg Hardy had an 11th sack season in 2012 and plays opposite Charles Johnson.
He really played well last year, Jim. When you talk about
Jay Cutler, you really suck.
One of the surprise units in the NFL was the defensive front for the defensive lineman for the Carolina Panthers.
Firing out to the left.
Causing my game.
Well, we see it more and more. Football thrown behind the line of scrimmage. They do it that time. Nice catch, but a loss of yards on the play.
Nickel formation here for the defense. Offense ready for action coming out of their timeout. Bennett's lined up in the slot. That's a failed conversion, but you might as well look at it.
You motherfucker.
Going back the other way.
That's what all defensive coordinators love to see. When they don't have to blitz, and one of their defensive linemen gets a sack without any blitzing.
Newton in shotgun formation, challenging the defenders to the right.
Now they get you.
The Bears' defensive line was led by the one and only Julius Peppers.
When you play the Bears, your offense, the first thing you have to think of is, how are we going to block Julius Peppers? It usually takes two offensive linemen to get that job done.
It's a second and five here. To the ground here. He'll be taken down about 3 yards short of the first.
Oh, I hope he dies.
In this defense, they are tough. When you run that football, they got some men up front. And that time they stopped that run just for a short game.
After that last carry, it's third and three. Newton's going to take the snap from the shotgun.
And near midfield, fourth down, what do? I got the answer right here. You punt it. Play field position. Make the other offense drive the length of the field to score.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I'm coaching.
Idiot. Swat down the throw by the QB.
On the way, third down. Cutler is going to take it from the gun. Jay Cutler with the deep ball. And it falls.
Deep passes in the NFL, they always serve a purpose. You're not always going to get the completion, but at least it gets the defense.
I hate this game.